super bright. Switch up the way I think. All positivity, cause I'm too busy doing me. Last week I was different.
Stars, this is Douglas.
And I'm Elisa, rolling in on this Tuesday morning.
Today is Tuesday, September 15th.
And it's an e-week for special areas.
It's National Online Learning Day.
A special shout out goes to our stars who are learning at home and the teachers who are zooming around to teach them.
Today's happy habit is number 5, seek first to understand, then to be understood.
It's all about listening and paying attention to the one who's talking.
I may have a different idea than another student or teacher, but I still listen to them.
Me too. I use my eyes, ears, heart, and mind to listen to the speaker.
Be sure you use your eyes to look,
ears to listen,
mind to understand, and heart to care.
This is an easy habit to use at your home too, by listening to your parents.
Listen up to hear about some great leaders.
It's time for Leadership Lookout. Miss Wallace's and Mrs. Christensen's class was caught modeling habit 6, synergize. When one student was feeling defeated and ready to quit, the whole class rallied behind and everyone came out a winner.
Caden and Mrs. Pennell's and in Miss Swanson's class was caught modeling habit 4. Caden is always showing others what great listening looks like. He can hear and so can everyone else around him.
Keep leading, stars!
We want to wish a happy birthday to the one and only
Nurse Bailey. She helps us when we are sick or hurt and deserves a day to celebrate.
Today's lunch is a hot dog, coney dog, or chicken Alfredo.
We'll have green beans. If that doesn't appeal to you, pick the fresh veggie tray or some fruit instead.
Sounds tasty. We have a fabulous joke. What do you give a lemon when it's sick?
I don't know. What?
A lemonade.
The jokes have been coming on in.
Be sure you write your joke neatly so we can read it.
You can use the mailbox by the library or type it and send it to abetvjokes@gmail.com.
Miss Puddle's second graders are here to lead the pledge.
Over to you.
Hi, my name is Julian.
Hi, I'm Charlotte.
Hi, my name is Avery.
Hi, my name is Miles.
Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Learning to be a good listener is an important life skill. There are many ways to be a good listener.
First, a good listener makes eye contact. Making eye contact is polite and shows that you are paying attention.
Second, a good listener is patient. There's nothing worse than talking to someone who seems like they are in a hurry.
Third, a good listener does not interrupt. Always let the person you are speaking to finish their thought. Don't move the topic of the conversation away from them. Your personal experiences can wait.
Next, a good listener asks questions. Asking questions shows that you are listening and actually interested.
Fifth, a good listener tries to relate to the topic. You can say yeah when you agree or cool when something they're saying is cool.
Sixth, use positive body language. This makes the speaker feel more comfortable.
Seventh, a good listener does not check his or her phone while somebody else is talking. That's just rude.
Also, a good listener is open-minded. Try not to have all the crazy opinions, but try to understand where the person is coming from.
In addition, a good listener shows that he or she cares. Show empathy for what the other person is sharing to make them feel that you understand them.
Finally, a good listener remembers what you've said.
you remember what they say and ask them about it later, they will think you are a caring friend.
Remember that good speakers aren't always the best listeners. If you follow these suggestions, you'll be on your way to being a fantastic listener.
Thank you.